Hello, I'm Dr. B.V. Rao of Usha Clinic and founder of the website qmedicaldoubts.blogspot.in and Dr. Raghava medicaldoubts.in. In these videos, I am trying to make the general public know about the general diseases and to provide basic knowledge to the medicos. Today, I am going to discuss about the bleeding peptic ulcer. Bleeding peptic ulcer is the result of negligence of treatment and sober habits like alcohol consumption, etc. In a seriously examined patient, the risk of surgical interventions are too much. So a physician should always consult a surgeon in the early stages of hemorrhage. It is said that the sooner we operate and fewer the transfusions given, the better will be the result. A patient with a persistent hemorrhage for more than 48 hours should undergo exploration if the age of the patient is more than 45 years. The risk is more if the bleeding is continued for more than 48 hours. In this case, depending on the amount of bleeding, the surgeon should go for operation earlier. In case of younger patients, the bleeding becomes recurrent or continuous for 48 hours unabated by medical treatment, exploration is advised. Pre-operative management. Along with the antacids, the patient was using the one may try cold milk drink to stop bleeding. Adequate replacement of blood is very much essential before the start of the operation. The patient should be well sedated before giving anesthesia. Operation steps. Right upper paramedian incision or upper midline incision should be made according to the surgeon's choice. After exploring the peritoneal cavity, the stomach and the duodenum are carefully examined for the ulcer. It may so happen that the bleeding ulcer lies on the posterior wall of the stomach. In that case, the lesser sac of the peritoneum should be explored through an avascular area on the gastrocolic fomentum. In case of bleeding gastric ulcer, if the stomach can be well mobilized, the patient's condition permits and the position of the ulcer is typical, partial gastrectomy is the operation of the choice. Alternatively, if one is not sure of the position of the ulcer, the gastrectomy should be performed and the inside of the stomach is looked for. If the bleeding ulcer lies very high in the stomach, the bleeding should be stopped by local measures such as underrunning the bleeding ulcer or by trying the left gastric artery. In this case, vagotomy should be performed with the idea that it opens up arteriovenous shunts to take away the blood from the mucosa along with a drainage procedure as gastrojejunostomy or pyloroscopy. In gastrotomy, if erosions are seen as the cause of bleeding, again vagotomy and drainage procedure is the operation of choice. Often these erosions restrict themselves in the distal half of the stomach and a parietal gastrectomy should be performed. In case of bleeding duodenal ulcer, a longitudinal incision is made on the anterior wall of the pyloroduodenal segment. Bleeding is arrested by stitches placed underrun the floor of the ulcer or by ligature of the gastroduodenal artery. Then the incision is closed transversely to make it a conventional pyloroplasty or operation which should be accompanied by vagotomy. That is all about the bleeding peptic ulcer and the operation. In the next video, we'll discuss about some other diseases, about peptic ulcer and some other procedures of the operation. Thank you.